Cannabidiol, also known as CBD, is so hot right now. It's sold in pills, as an oil, in gummies, as a cream, a vape liquid, and even in bath bombs. CBD is one member of a group of over 100 chemicals called cannabinoids that are produced by the marijuana plant. Tetrahydrocannabinol, or THC, is another much more famous one. It's the reason weed gets people high. So THC and CBD are produced by the same plant and their structures look really similar, which raises the question, could you fail a drug test by using CBD? Even though the structures of THC and CBD look very similar, they act quite differently in your body. So far, the evidence suggests that CBD does not get you high, nor does it produce any of the other classic THC symptoms. Hunger, dizziness, hunger, difficulty concentrating, hunger, nausea, hunger, elevated heart rate, hunger, dry mouth, hunger, and the munchies. And what about drug tests? Urine marijuana drug screens test for one specific metabolite of THC. They don't test for CBD. But there's two pieces of maybe bad news. First, because the structure of CBD and THC are so similar, some scientists were concerned that CBD might be converted to THC by your stomach acid. It's not too crazy of a hypothesis. Acids catalyze ring closures every day of the week. And a few years ago, some researchers did in fact use a delicious-sounding mixture called simulated gastric fluid, which is basically acid, table salt, and a few other things to convert CBD to THC. But they did this reaction in a test tube, or a beaker, or maybe an Erlenmeyer flask. The point is, it wasn't in a person. A few studies since then have fed people pretty high doses of CBD and tested for THC in their blood and stomach contents, finding none. But CBD isn't out of the woods yet. The bigger problem is that because over-the-counter CBD products are not regulated by the FDA, there's no guarantee that you're getting what the label says you're getting. Back in 2017, doctors at UPenn analyzed the CBD and THC concentrations of 84 CBD oils, tinctures, and vape liquids, and found measurable levels of THC in 18 of the samples. That's more than 1 in 5. The levels were generally low, but possibly high enough to set up a drug test. By the way, in that same study, only 26 of the samples had CBD levels within 90 to 110% of what was on the label. If you're in the market for CBD, make sure you look at the specific product certificate of analysis first. This is a test performed by an independent lab to make sure the label is accurate. Make sure that the lab checked for THC too. Sometimes you'll see relatively high levels of THC right there in the fine print. You should also know that CBD has not been FDA approved for concentration, anxiety, stress, depression, pain, or almost any of the other things it's been advertised for. As of right now, there's only one FDA approved drug containing CBD for hard to treat seizures. So, could you fail a drug test by taking CBD? We gotta remind you that we're a YouTube channel and not a doctor. But our conclusion is, if you're 100% sure that your product contains CBD and nothing else, you're extremely unlikely to fail a drug test for marijuana. But given how often CBD products are not accurately labeled and how often THC was detected in them, it actually seems plausible that you might fail a drug test because of a mislabeled or poorly analyzed CBD product. So in the end, your mom is probably right. Better safe than sorry. Have you ever had any unexpected CBD experiences? Let us know in the comments, and we'll see you next week.